what way can Guanyin, the compassionate Bodhisattva, save and protect us from every danger? What 10 great dangers does the merciful compassionate Guanyin save us from? How can we invoke her help? Which sutra mentions the 10 great protections? Buddha Weekly presents the 10 Great Protections of Guan Yin. Before we begin, if you like this video, please subscribe to the Buddha Weekly channel and turn on notifications. Millions of devotees around the world call on the name of Guan Yin, Goddess of Mercy, in times of need, fear, or despair. Aside from her best-known role as compassion embodied, she is, after all, none other than Avalokiteshvara. She also protects against the 10 great fears. Interestingly, one of the 10 great protections is protection from politics.
Avalokiteshvara, also called Guan Yin, Chenrezig, Kannon, and many other names, is immediately synonymous with the word Bodhisattva. He or she is the quintessential Bodhisattva, the superhero savior. Her fame was first well established by Shakyamuni Buddha in the 25th chapter of the Wondrous Lotus Sutra, where Buddha makes it clear that Guan Yin is ready to rescue all sentient beings. The 10 great protections, as they are called in the Lotus Sutra, are the protective actions of a mother protecting her children. Like a mother, she doesn't question her child's integrity, even going so far as to rescue her sons and daughters from prison. Even Avalokiteshvara's name is virtually the definition of a bodhisattva, perceiver of the world's suffering. He, or she, is not just the listener to our cries and suffering. The great Bodhisattva is the original savior.
Guan Yin is famous for rescues from harm, especially well known for rescues of anyone who calls out her name. Her devotees tell hundreds of tales of her rescues. When in trouble, we might simply call out her name Guan Yin. Or we can say or chant her mantra, Om Mani Padme Hum, sometimes called the Mani Mantra. Or, you can just say, Namo Guanyin Bodhisattva. The traditional Chinese chant would be,
Nan Wu Guan Shi Yin Pusa.
For any praise or mantra, it is considered auspicious to repeat 3 times, 7 times, 21 times, or 108 times. 3 times is for the 3 jewels, Buddha, Dharma and Sangha. It also represents the 3 great ones, Guanyin, Manjushri and Vajrapani, representing compassion, wisdom and power. 3 also represents the 3 meditations, or entrances to liberation. If you chant 7 times, this is for the steps of the Buddha. In Sutra, on his birth to our world, he took 7 steps. 7 also represents the 7 degrees of enlightenment and also the 7 purities. 21 is considered auspicious, as it is 3 times the 7. Most auspicious is 108 repetitions.
In Buddhism, there are 108 delusions to be overcome, so we chant 108 mantras or praises as a remedy. Likewise, chanting 108 praises or mantras activates and purifies the 108 lines of energy, or nadis, and 108 pressure points of the inner body. Chant along now with the praise to Guanyin. Visualize Guanyin in front of you, sending healing and protective white light as you chant.
Some Buddhists might see Guanyin as a father, as Avalokiteshvara or Chenrezig. There is no difference, as all Buddhas can appear in any form.
In Buddhism, labels are just labels, and the name of the compassionate Bodhisattva is another imputed label that just helps us relate to the enlightened concept in our daily lives. Guanyin's practice came to China as early as the 1st century AD from India, and from there spread to devotees in Japan and Korea. The compassionate Bodhisattva can be visualized as either female or male, but most visualize her as goddess Guanyin. Yet, she is not separate or different from the male four-armed Avalokiteshvara, thousand-armed Avalokiteshvara, and dozens of forms and emanations: loving, wrathful, passionate, fiery, protective, but always compassionate. Compassion wears many faces, many of them the aspects of Avalokiteshvara, also known as Guanyin, Guanxiyin, Guanyin, Guanyin, Kannon, Kunyam, Hanzion, Guanyam, Guanam, and many, many other names. What's in a name? The qualities of mercy and compassion, the appearance of beauty, motherly wisdom, tenderness, the activities of kindness, help, protection, nurturing, mother.
Avalokiteshvara is so intensely focused on saving everyone from suffering that he arises simultaneously in many forms, including one with 1,000 arms and multiple heads, and still, the great Bodhisattva hero never rests. The Lotus Sutra describes Avalokiteshvara as a Bodhisattva who can take the form of any type of god, including Indra or Brahma, any type of Buddha, any type of king or Chakravartin, or even any kind of heavenly guardian, including Vajrapani and Vaisravana, as well as any gender, male or female, adult or child, human or non-human being, in order to teach the Dharma to sentient beings. Although Avalokiteshvara is in many, many prominent sutras, it is in chapter 25 of the Lotus Sutra that we learn of the 10 salvations, protections or deliverances, of Guanyin. These are also called the 10 protections. Simply think of Guanyin or Avalokiteshvara, in any of her forms, or say the mantra, Om Mani Padme Hum. When you think of Guanyin, she is already there. Another practice is to recite the sutra verses as a protective meditation, as we will demonstrate in a moment.
Guanyin protects from fire, water, falling, politics, prison, poisons, demons, evil beasts, disputes and war. Guanyin demands nothing of her followers. As an enlightened one, free from attachments, she has no need of offerings, worship, praise, or devotions. It is the Buddhist follower who needs the offering, worship, praise, devotions. These acts are positive acts of karma, Guanyin's gift to us. She gives us the opportunity to extinguish our past impurities and negative karmic acts with meritorious acts. She asks only one thing, that you share her value of compassion and metta, love for all sentient beings. Here are 10 verses of the many protective verses from chapter 25 of the Lotus Sutra, commonly said out loud. Chant them with faith, to help bring the blessings of Guanyin. If there are people who wish to harm you, by pushing you into the great pit of inferno, think of the power of Bodhisattva Guanyin, the inferno pit will be transformed into a water pond.
南无观世音菩萨。
If you are drifting in a great ocean and facing imminent danger with dragons, fish, and other demons, think of the power of Bodhisattva Guanyin. The waves will be unable to swallow you.
南无观世音菩萨。
If you are at the summit of Mount Sumeru and someone pushes you off the edge, think of the power of Bodhisattva Kuanyin. You will be suspended in midair like the sun in the sky.
Namo Guanyin Pusa.
If you are suffering from the punishment of government and your life is about to end by execution, think of the power of Bodhisattva Guanyin. The sword will be splintered into pieces.
南无观世音菩萨。
If you are being locked in a prison and your hands and feet are being bound by chains and fetters, think of the power of Bodhisattva Kuanyin. You will be released and freed.
南无观世音菩萨。
If there are people who wish to harm you by curses or poisonous herbs, think of the power of Bodhisattva Guanyin. The effects will be bounced back to the originator.
Namo Guanyin Pusa.
If you face harm from vicious zombies, poisonous dragons, or various demons, think of the power of Bodhisattva Guanyin. No one will dare to harm you.
Namo Guanyin Pusa.
If you are surrounded by evil beasts with sharp fangs and fearful claws, think of the power of Bodhisattva Guanyin. They will quickly flee and scamper away in all directions.
Namo Guanyin Pusa.
If you have disputes before the court, or are fearful in the midst of the war, think of the power of Bodhisattva Guanyin. All enemies full of resentment will retreat.
Namo Guanyin Pusa.
If there are any who wish to give birth to a child, they should worship by giving offerings to Bodhisattva Guanyin, who will bestow them a child blessed with good fortune, virtue, and wisdom.
南无观世音菩萨。
In the Lotus Sutra, Guanyin is properly titled Bodhisattva, perceiver of the cries of the world. These fears represent all fears. It is said that the Bodhisattva Guanyin can save from every danger. Simply call out her name or chant her mantra Om Mani Padme Hum. Although Guanyin is open to all and has compassion for all, don't wait for dangers or fear to call out her name. Take refuge in Buddha Dharma and Sangha, the three jewels, and chant her mantra often. 108 times for auspiciousness and protection from the 10 fears, and enjoy beautiful meditative images of the glorious compassionate Bodhisattva. It can be helpful to visualize Guanyin in front of you, with white healing and protective light absorbing into you. Please dedicate the merit for the benefit of all sentient beings.
Namo Guanyin Pusa.
this video, please subscribe to the Buddha Weekly channel and turn on notifications. Your subscription helps us create regular content for Buddhist practice. Leave us a comment below with ideas for topics you'd like us to cover in future. Buddha Weekly, helping to spread the Dharma. Thank you.